Good morning, one and all. So in the last class, you started with a new topic, that is conditional independence. What is that? Conditional independence. So we have seen what is independence means. What is independence? That is unconditional independence. Unconditional independence means probability of A intersection B should be equal to probability of A into probability of B, where probability of B is always greater than 0. It should not be equal to 0. It is always positive. Now we will discuss what is unconditional independence. Now we will discuss conditional independence. Okay. Now what is the definition? So two events A and B are said to be conditionally independent given another event C whose probability is always positive if and only if probability of A intersection B given C is equal to probability of A given C into probability of B given C. So the proof is quite easy. You can just go with the multiplication rule. Okay. Now, so this is also one of the important statements. Independence does not imply conditional independence and vice versa. Here independence means generally unconditional. What is that? That is unconditional. Unconditional independence does not imply conditional independence and vice versa. Okay. So which means if A and B are independent, does not imply they are conditionally independent and vice versa. Okay. Now, so we have started with an example. So we are considering tosses of a fair coin, two independent tosses of a fair coin, and these are the events H1, H2, D. H1 is the first toss is ahead. H2 is the second toss is ahead. D is that the two tosses have different results. Now, so we'll see what are the, okay, what is H1? H1 says, first toss is head. So what are the possibilities of event H1? So we are tossing the fair coin two times, two independent trials. Head tail. What is H2? Second toss is a head, which means tail head. Correct? Now, what is D? The event D says, so the two tosses are different. Different means it can be tail head or head tail. So we have seen the probability of H1 H2 also. So let me write here. Here, what is the probability of H1? So simple, that is very simple. What is that? So the number of elements of H1 divided by all possible outcomes. Here, let me write here. So in this experiment, the sample space has got four elements. What are they? HH, HT, TH, TT. No need to mention each and every time. So that is 2 by 4. That is 1 by 2. Probability of H2 also. Here also it has got two elements. So the number of elements in 2 by 4, that is also 1 by 2. What is the probability of D? It is also probability of D equal to 1 by 2. So the probability of H1, the probability of H2 and the probability of D all are equal to 1 by 2 or equal to 0.5. Now, so here what is they are asking, what is the what they are asking. Okay, so let me write what is H1 intersection H2. What are the common elements of H1 H2? What are they? You check here. H1 H2 common elements. In H1 we have HH, H2 also HH, HT, TH. Okay, so only one is common. Correct? What is that? HH. Now what is the probability of H1 intersection H2? What is that? So the number of elements in H1 intersection H2, that is 1. Total number of elements are 4 or 0.25. This is 0.5. Now here I can clearly say that, what I can say? What I can say? So the probability of H1 intersection H2, that equal to 1/4, that is also equal to probability of H1 into probability of H2. What is probability of H1? 1/2. Probability of H2 also 1/2, that is also 1/4. So these two are equal, which means, what you can say, which means therefore H1 and H2 are independent. What independent? What independent? They are independent unconditionally. They are independent unconditionally. Okay? But, so we are checking for conditional independence. Okay, now, so I want to find out what is H1 intersection H2 given D. I want to find out H1 intersection H2 given D. This is the conditional probability. So, first of all, what is H1 intersection H2? How many elements are there? Only one. What is that? HH. So HH given D, given even, what is D? What is D? Event which says that tosses are different. So what is this probability? So here they are same, but given that, what the condition we are asking for? Different results in the two independent tosses. Obviously it is zero. Okay, now so this is zero because there is no such element. So H1 intersection H2 has got one element, that is HH, but what the condition is asking? They should be different, but they are same here, isn't it? Okay, that's why there is no such element, so the probability will be zero. But so here, can you tell me what is probability of H1 given D? H1 given D. Okay, what is the answer? Probability of H1 given D. Think about this probability. So before that, how to write this conditional probability? That is probability of H1 intersection D by probability of D. So here let me write H1 intersection D elements. H1 intersection D elements. How many are there? What are the common elements between the event H1 and the event D? Let us go back. H1D. Yeah, H1D. So the common elements of H1 and D. This is H1, this is D. HT. HT is the common here. Only one is common. Okay, what is that HT? So HT, only one element, that is common. What is the probability now? Probability of H1 intersection D will be equal to, obviously only one element is there over four elements, the total possible outcomes. Now in the same way, here what is probability of H1 given D now? So this is how much? 1 by 4 by, what is the probability of D? We have found it already. What is that? Probability of D how much? 1 by 2. So here, so here 1 by 4 and here 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2. In the same way, what is probability of H2 given D? What the formula? Probability of H2 intersection D by probability of D, by probability of D. So here, next, so the common elements between, you have to find out between what? H2 and D, how many elements are there in common between two events, H2 and D? Let us go back. H2 and D, how many are common there? Only one. What is that? TH, TH. Only one is common. So TH, what is that? Common element is TH. So H2 intersection D has only one common element, that is TH. Now what is the probability of H2 intersection D will be now? Only one element given out of four. Now what is probability of H2 given D? Sorry. Probability of H2 given D. So this probability by probability of D, that is 1 by 2. Here also it is 1 by 2. Here you can write like this. So I will summarize everything at one place. Okay, I will summarize everything at one place. Here now, so probability of H1 intersection H2 is same as probability of H1 and probability of H2, but probability of H1 intersection H2 given D is zero. Is zero. Furthermore, probability of H1 given D is 1 by 2. Probability of H2 given D is also 1 by 2. Which means this is 0, these two are 1 by 2, 1 by 2. That's why I can say that probability of H1 intersection H2 given D is not equal to probability of H1 given D and probability of H2 given D. Now what can you write now here? What can you write? So from this statement, this equation 1 let us call, this equation 2 let us call. So from equation 1, what does it say? 1 implies equation, therefore equation 1 implies H1 and H2 are unconditionally independent. But equation 2 says that H1 and H2 are, what is that? Are not conditionally independent. Are not conditionally independent. Here H1 and H2 are independent, but they are not conditionally independent. Okay, so just because these two events are independent, it does not mean that they are conditionally independent. And reverse may also be true. Just because they are conditionally independent, it does not mean that they will be independent. Please make a note of this. Unconditionally also very, very important. Unconditionally means normal independence. Conditionally means based on some another event. Okay. So this example illustrates the statement that I made. This statement. What statement? This statement. So unconditional independence does not imply conditional independence, and vice versa. It may happen reverse also. Okay. Now, so that is about this problem. Now, so let us go to the another kind of problem here. So please make a note of this. Till now we have discussed independent of only two events. Okay, you can go back here. Every time I have been referring for independence of two events only, not more than two. Everything is referred to only two events: independence, conditional independence, etc., etc. All those things were discussed only for two events. But in case if there are more than two events, how to check independence? So if there are more than two events, so you should be very cautious while discussing about independence. Okay. Now I am taking for three events. How can you say these three events are independent? Here independent means by default unconditional. No need to write each and every time. Okay. By default, independence by default means unconditional independence. Okay. Now, so if A1, A2, A3 are independent by satisfying the following condition. What are they? So you need to satisfy four conditions. What the first one? P of A1 intersection A2 should be equal to P of A1 into P of A2. A1, A3, A2, A3. Okay. So all these three are called pairwise independence. What they are called? Pairwise independence. Which means what? A1 is independent of A2. A1 is independent of A3. A2 is independent of A3. Okay. If you take any two at a time, they are independent of each other. But what is the fourth condition? P of A1 intersection A2 intersection A3 should also be equal to P of A1 into P of A2 into P of A3. Okay. So these are the four conditions that need to be satisfied for three events to be independent. Okay. So four are very, very important. Okay. The first three equations are known as pairwise independence. The last one is final independence. So for any three events to be independent, they need to satisfy all these four equations. All are important. Okay. Yeah. So there is a one more important statement. Just because the first three are true, it does not imply fourth one will be true. Okay. So you cannot assume that. So these three are true and fourth one will also be true. No, it may not happen so. Okay. So sometimes what happens? They are pairwise independent, but not independent as a whole. Okay. So that's why you need to verify all these four equations. You cannot assume that the first three are true by default, fourth one will be true. No. Okay. It may not be the case like this. And you can also see that fourth one is true, it does not imply that the first three will be true. Okay, so that's why you need to verify all four equations to verify. You need to verify all these four equations to check whether the given three equations are the given three events are independent or not. Okay, so one more time I am referring this last sentence. What it says is, just because these three equations are true, it does not mean that the fourth one is also true. You cannot take it guaranteed. Okay, and also you cannot check just fourth one and you can assume that these three are true. No. Okay, so you must verify all four equations to identify whether the given three events are independent or not. Okay, so let us take a simple example. So I'm taking the same example just now we have seen. Okay, now let us see whether all these three events are independent or not. Now we are taking three events. Okay, now anyway, so just now we have written everything, but so let me write what is h1, what is h2, all those things. So no need to write separately, I am writing directly. H1 is the first task is the head tail. The probability of h1 is 1/2. I am writing directly. H2 is the second task is head, which means head tail, with the probability of h2 is again 1/2. D is the different results, which means h tail h, so the probability of D also 1/2. Now we have to verify whether all these three events are independent or not. So just now we have solved the same problem for conditional independence, that is different. Now I am asking the independence of these three events. Please be careful. Okay, straight away. So what is H1 intersection H2 elements? How many are there? H1, H2, HH. What is the probability of H1 intersection H2? 1/4. Correct? Next. Now, so H1, H2, H1D, how many are there? H1D, HT, HT, only one. Implies what the probability of H1 intersection D, that is also equal to 1/4. H1, H2 is over, H1, H2D. H2 intersection D is how much? Common elements of H2D. TH, TH. Okay. What is the probability? Probability of H2 intersection D is also equal to 1/4. Now finally, what is the probability that, so I am taking the common elements between all these three events, H1, H2 and D. What are they? How many are common between all these three events? How many are there? How many common elements are there between all these three events? How many are there? You just verify. Okay, no one is common. Nothing is common between all these three. Okay, nothing. Empty or null set. What is the probability now? Zero. Probability of empty set is zero or null set is zero. Now, here, so I can write the following. What I can write? So the probability of H1 intersection H2, that is 1/4, it is also equal to probability of H1 into probability of H2. What is that? 1/2 into 1/2. What is the probability of H1? Just verify. Probability of H1 is 1/2, H2 is 1/2, D also 1/2. Now, next. I can also verify that. What I can verify? Probability of H1 intersection D 1/4, that is also equal to probability of H1 into probability of D. What is that? 1/2 into 1/2. I can also verify that probability of H2 intersection D is also equal to 1/4. That is also equal to probability of H2 into the probability of D, that is 1/2 into 1/2. But finally, what I can say is probability of H1 intersection H2 intersection D, that is 0. Okay. So, but probability of H1 into probability of H2 into probability of D is not 0. What is the probability of H1, probability of H2, probability of D? Probability of H1 into probability of H2 into probability of D equal to 1/2 into 1/2 into 1/2. How much is that? 1/8. This is 1/8. This is 1/8. Okay. So these two are not equal now. Now what has happened here? Now, so here the summary is, so the probability of H1 intersection H2 was equal to probability of H1 into probability of H2. In the same way, the probability of H1 intersection D is also equal to probability of H1 into the probability of D. Finally, the probability of H2 intersection D is also equal to probability of H2 into the probability of D. But finally, the probability of H1 intersection H2 intersection D was not equal to probability of H1, probability of H2, and probability of D. This is equation 1, 2, 3, 4. By looking at all these three, what you can say? They are not satisfying all four equations. That's why H1, comma, H2 and D are what? Not independent. Why they are not independent? Because they don't satisfy all four equations. But what is happening here? They are satisfying first three equations. But that's why they are called pairwise independent. So this is the statement I want to make. Here they are pairwise independent, but not independent as a whole, because they only satisfy first three equations, not the fourth one. So that's why you cannot jump to a conclusion. Just because the first three equations are true, it does not mean that the fourth equation will also be true. No. Okay, here. So since the fourth equation is not satisfied, that's why they are not independent. But only thing is, they are pairwise independent. What is pairwise? So if you take two at a time, they're independent. But if you take three at a time, they are not independent. Finally, the conclusion is they are not independent. Okay. So now, this is what I want to make. Pairwise independence does not imply independence. In the previous example, they are pairwise independent, but they are not independent as a whole. Okay. So let us take one more problem. So we are referring to these problems to check the independence of more than two events. Okay. If there are two events, we know the conditions are very simple. If there are more than two events, you need to verify so many equations. Okay. You need to verify four equations as of now. Okay. Now, so let us take this example. Consider two independent roll of a fair die. Here die means six-sided die. and the following events. I am taking three events for the experiment. First roll is 1, 2 or 3. The first roll is 3, 4 or 5. The sum of two rolls is 9. Okay. So we are rolling a fair die two times. Here die I am taking a 6 face die. So what are the sample space elements? How many will be there? 6 square, that is 36. There will be 36 elements in the sample space. You know all those things. You need to write each and every time. 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, so on. Okay. Now what is the event S is? What is the event S is? The first roll is 1, 2 or 3. The first roll is 1, 2 or 3. The first roll is 1 comma 2 or 3. So what are the possibilities? You write the possibilities. Okay. So these are the possible outcomes of event A and event B. What event A says? The first roll is 1, 2 or 3. If the first roll is 1, second roll may be 1, second roll may be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In the same way, the first roll is 2, second may be 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Event B says the first roll is 3, 4, 5. If the first roll is 3, second can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on. These are the possible outcomes of event A and event B. Now, how many are there in common between A and B? How many are there in common between A and B? How many are there? First of all, number of elements in A. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 into 3 rows, 18. B, same. In B also there are 18 elements. Okay. Event A has got 18 entries. Event B also got has got 18 entries. But how many are in common? The common elements between event A and event B. How many are there? You check. So 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. So the last row of this and the first row of this, they are in common. Only common are how many? So I'm not writing anything else. A intersection B has got how many elements? 6. The last row, and that is also first row of B. I've indicated with a red line. Anything else? No. So, anyway, I'm writing the probabilities. What is the probability of A? In event A, how many elements are there? 18. By total number of elements of the experiment, how many? 36. That equal to 18 by 36 means 1 by 2. Probability of B. In B also there are 18 elements. 18 by 36. That is also equal to 1 by 2. Now, probability of A intersection B is how much? In A intersection B, we got 6 elements, 6 by 36. That is equal to 1 by 6. Okay. Now, so that is about A, B and the intersection. What is event C says? Event C says, sum is how much? The sum of two rolls is 9. Sum should be 9. Now what are the possibilities of C? What are they? 6, 3, 3, 6, 5, 4, 4, 5. Sum should be 9. So there are 4 possible outcomes of event C. Any other possibilities? Please verify. Only 4. So that's why the probability of C equal to number of elements in C, 4 by 36. That equal to 1 by 9. Now, so A intersection C, common elements of A intersection C, how many are there? A intersection C. A intersection C, how many are there? You verify. A, let me write C here also, so that now check the common elements between A and C. So 1 1, how many are there? Only one. What is that? 3 6. Correct. So A intersection C is 3 comma 6. So what is the probability now? One element given by 36. Now what is B intersection C? You check. B intersection C, how many are there? 3 6. 3 6. 5 4. 5 4. 4 5. 4 5. How many are there? 3. The common elements are 3. 3 in number. What is the probability now? Probability of B intersection C will be 3 by 36. How much is that? 1 by 12. Now how many are common in both, I mean in all A intersection B intersection C, how many are there? Verify. A intersection B intersection C, only one. What is that? 3 6. Now what is the probability now? Only one element, 1 over 36. So let me write all the probabilities at one place. So the probability of A is 1 by 2. The probability of B is also equal to 1 by 2. The probability of C equal to how much? 4 by 36. Let me write 4 by 36 only. Now probability of A intersection B, how much you got? A intersection B, probability of A intersection B, how much? 1 by 6. This is 1 by 6. Probability of B intersection C, how much you got? 3 by 36. 3 by 36. Probability of A intersection C, how much? 1 by 36. 1 by 36. probability of A intersection B intersection C equal to 1/36. Now, by looking all these probabilities, what you can write is the probability of A intersection B that equal to 1/6, but that is not equal to probability of A into probability of B. What is the probability of A into probability of B? 1/2 into 1/2, that is 1/4 only, correct? In the same way, probability of B intersection C equal to, what is the probability of B intersection C? 3/36. That is also not equal to probability of B into probability of C. What is probability of B into probability of C? 1/2 into 4/36. Correct? In the same way, probability of A intersection C equal to how much? Probability of A intersection C equal to 1/36. But that is not equal to probability of A into probability of C. Probability of A is 1/2. Probability of C is how much? 4/36. Okay. But the probability of A intersection B intersection C is equal to how much? 1/36. That is also equal to probability of A into probability of B into probability of C. Why? Because probability of A is 1/2, probability of B also equal to 1/2, probability of C is also equal to 4/36. So these two will cancel out, that is also equal to 1/36. So this is true, and these are not true. I mean, now what you can say? They are not pairwise independence. Okay, they don't satisfy first three conditions, but they satisfy fourth condition. What the final answer would be? Still, the final answer would be what? A, B, and C are what? Not independent. Because they don't satisfy all four conditions, they only satisfy fourth condition. So what I want to say is, so even though the fourth statement is true, it does not mean that remaining three will be true. Okay, so that is about independence of the events which are more in number. Yeah, is not enough for independence. Okay, so generally students make mistake by checking only this condition. What they will do is, they check this condition and they assume that, they think that they are independent. But no, in this case, even though this condition is true, but remaining three are not satisfied. Okay, so please be careful while checking the independence of more than two events. You need to verify pairwise independence and finally the final equation. Okay, so just because the last equation is true, it does not mean that they are independent. Okay, in this case, what's happening? If you directly check this condition, it is true. So by checking only one condition, you cannot jump to a conclusion that they are independent. You have to verify remaining three also. In this case, they happen to be not true. They don't satisfy remaining three conditions. So the final answer would be they are not independent. Okay. Right. Now, so next, the final thing would be, so this is a definition of independent of several events. I have told you for only three events. If there are four, what would happen? If there are four, what do you do? Suppose there are four events, a1, a2, a3, a4. How to check independence of these four events? What will you do? you first verify pairwise independence, which means verify whether A1 is independent of A2, A3 and A4, which means you have to verify A1, A2, you have to verify independence of pairwise independence A1, A2, A1, A3, A1, A4. Next, you have to verify whether A2 is independent of A3 or A4, which means you have to verify A2, A3, A2, A4. Finally, you have to verify whether A3, A4 are independent or not, which means A3, A4. So this is called checking the pairwise independence. What is this called? Pairwise. Finally, you have to verify independent of all events. What is that? Probability of A1 intersection, A2 intersection, A3 intersection, A4. That should be equal to probability of A1, probability of A2, probability of A3, probability of A4. So generally, people make mistake by verifying only this last condition. What they do is they verify this condition and they say that they are independent. No, you have to verify the pairwise independence and the overall independence. Then if all are satisfied, they are independent, otherwise not. Okay. Here you have to verify 6 equations, 6 plus 1, total 7. Now this is the final definition. We will say that the events A1, A2, A n are independent if probability of I belongs to set S, AI, AI equal to product I belongs to S, P of AI, where S is subset. Okay. Anyway, so this is about independence of several events. Please be careful while verifying the independence of events which are more in number. Maybe 2, 3, 4, not 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So please remember this point. Just because the last condition is 2, it does not mean that they are independent. You have to verify pairwise independence, and after that, this final equation. If all are satisfied, then you can say that they are independent. Otherwise, not. Okay. Okay. So with this, we complete a unit 1. So I'll try to give you some more assignment problems from this unit. So in the next class, we start with the second unit. Thank you.